I chose to exhibit this series in Israel because I'm aware of the fact that the issues explored in this series are things that are of special relevance to Israel as they are to other Western cultures. In other words, the prevalence of eating disorders and also the prevalence of certain role models in the fashion industry have had quite a strong and often quite serious impact on young women. So that was one of the reasons I decided to show them in Israel. Another reason is that the works, I'm Jewish myself, and a lot of the works deal with issues that are slightly uncomfortable from a Jewish perspective. In other words, kind of taboos that I feel I'm sort of approaching. I come from a religious background, a religious Jewish background, and the idea of exploring the suffering, the contemporary suffering of women, especially in the glamour industry, is not something that you would expect a Jewish artist to explore. And it's particularly interesting to do that in Israel, because I suppose the two main taboos that I'm dealing with here is the impact of, if you like, sexuality, and also using Western art historical prototypes, especially things that come from sort of Christian mythology, as a kind of symbol of, you know, contemporary suffering, not in a religious way, in a secular way. For example, a lot of the paintings are painted in triptych format, you know, sets of three, which has a long art historical background from the Renaissance onwards in Christian art. But in modern art, they've been used by Max Beckmann and also Francis Bacon to represent the contemporary human condition. And I wanted to use that format of the triptych to explore the issues facing a lot of modern women, least of all in Israel. Well, it was two main events. First of all, I was in Israel in November 2007 when the Israeli model Hila died of anorexia. So I thought of doing the series of paintings based on that subject in Israel when I was offered the exhibition in this space. So a lot of the paintings were painted specifically for here. And the second was I was in Basel for the art fair and I saw a 500-year-old painting of the dead Christ by Holbein, which influenced me to start producing a series of contemporary paintings based on the idea of human suffering, but from a female perspective, in terms of anorexia. This is a very exciting space to fill because you've got these five enormous columns here. So when I first saw the space, it did influence me to make these paintings specifically for the space. If you like, I was thinking like the Parthenon in Athens. You have these women, the caryatides, supporting the building. So I thought of it in that term too. But to do contemporary caryatides, paintings that represent the period of the supermodel and all the dangers that come with the period of the supermodel. So, they were site-specific in that sense. You know, our society is very, very obsessed with the whole idea of celebrity and, of course, appearances, outward appearances. In a way, although this exhibition does deal with taboo issues, as we've discussed, I do actually think, although it seems strange to say it, that it's quite a moral exhibition in the sense that it's exploring some of the things that are wrong or at least difficult with our culture. The fact that the obsession with appearances can actually result in a lot of internal problems, which are based mainly on people feeling low self-esteem because they can't fulfill those extraordinary role models that the culture places on them. I mean, most women cannot be a supermodel, and yet pretty much every magazine goes on about how fantastic it is to be one. So, you know, the whole culture can't really fulfill what we're meant to, according to that kind of culture. We can't fulfill it, and that makes us feel bad. And that's what actually results in things like, I don't know, depression or eating disorders, anorexia, bulimia, and of course, drug addiction, sex addiction, pornography, a lot of those things are connected in the sense that they are ways of people escaping from feelings of low self-worth. And that's all tied in with the idea of, you know, the idea that you have to fulfill certain role models. I mean, for women, often they are made to feel bad if they don't look a certain way. It may be self-imposed, that feeling, but it still can have disastrous effects. I mean, the results of eating disorders today are far, you know, in terms of casualties, are probably hundreds of times any war. You know, and yet the war gets all the media coverage. Of course, it's tragic too, but, you know, in terms of the personal figures, the figures of people suffering and dying from this disorder, it's enormous. It's an international plague, and that's what defines, to a certain degree, contemporary life. You know, in 100 years, when people ask about the human condition at this time, beginning of the 21st century, that would be one of the defining characteristics. In men, obviously, there are some men who, and the figures are quite high, actually, also for men with eating disorders, but it often comes out in different ways, for example, in forms of addiction and in depressions and things like that, low self-esteem. That's the way it would come out amongst men, which is not often explored. I mean, obviously, it's explored by the experts and in the media, but in terms of making art out of it, making images that are sort of memorable, that are both attractive and disturbing, you know, beautiful and horrific. That's what I wanted to do. Often, paintings that deal with an issue that somebody actually has, because they have it, the painting can be too much for them. So in a sense, it's almost more important for people without the eating disorder to, you know, to bring their attention to, or people with a potential problem. Well, I don't know if it'll be a mirror, because everybody's life is so different that probably not exactly a mirror, but they may be interested in the fact that somebody's bringing attention to it in that way, or that it's a subject for art. I mean, that could be interesting for them, but I don't know how closely it would hit on their personal experience of it. Maybe it could. I mean, because often you have with these issues that people feel better at the fact that there's other people who they know are going through that, or who have an interest in what's going on.